Welcome to a new update. We had some strong seismic activity yesterday in Mindanao, Philippines, a borderline 6. Fortunately, not as strong as we anticipated, because we anticipated mid to high 6, potentially for or around the 31st. It happened in the morning of the 1st, and it was borderline 6. It also happened a bit east of the fluctuation that we had earlier, marking the regions of Asia from Lake Baikal in the north into the Indian Ocean. And that shows you that we cannot really be very accurate with those fluctuations. These are rough estimates, and the increased seismic activity may occur to the east or to the west of the purple band. So what are we going to have in the coming days? Some interesting planetary and lunar geometry. On the 31st, we had some critical geometry involving Mercury, and that will be followed by two lunar peaks that could potentially trigger some serious seismic activity, most likely around the 4th. We also see some critical planetary geometry involving Venus, and that will be later on the 3rd. So we have that lunar geometry pretty much in the middle. Overall, because we have planetary peaks on the 4th and the 5th, my estimate is that we could see some seismic increase from the 4th to the 6th. Most likely in the 6th magnitude range, mid 6, high 6 maybe. But because of that planetary and lunar geometry from the 31st to the 3rd of February, with the lunar geometry in between, there is a slight possibility of a serious seismic event around the 4th. Again, I'm not at all sure about it. I'm not saying there's a high probability. It is more like a slight possibility. But that would be something to keep in mind. If we look at the solar system, we see the critical geometry primarily on the 4th and the 5th. On the 4th, we have Sun, Venus and Jupiter in a conjunction. And then the next day, less than 24 hours later, we see Mercury, Sun and Uranus in a conjunction, followed by a lunar conjunction with the Sun, which is, in other words, a full moon. And I mark that here with the green line. And this is all coming together on the 4th and 5th of February. There is a possibility that there will be larger seismic activity following the next lunar peak on 6th February, but we're not there yet. So currently, I guess that we could see a seismic increase from the 4th, and that's really in a couple of days from the 4th to the 6th. And keep in mind, on the 4th, there is a slight possibility of a serious seismic event. And if we look at the atmospheric fluctuations, the latest that we picked up, it isn't all that much activity in the atmosphere currently, but on the 29th, we picked up a couple of fluctuations, and we see again a purple band here over Asia from Lake Baikal in the north down to the Indian Ocean that has been on the radar for several days now. And also to the west, purple band, and that marks the region from Afghanistan over Pakistan into the western part of the Indian Ocean, and we see India right in the middle. Interestingly, we've already seen magnitude 5.8 right in between in China. And if we count 6 days, we would end up around the 4th. And these areas could be a candidate for larger seismic activity if we look at the atmospheric fluctuations. But again, keep in mind, these are rough estimates, and not all larger earthquakes leave a footprint in the atmosphere. They do not announce themselves always. Then on the 31st, there was also some atmospheric fluctuation marking the region from western Alaska in the north, the Aleutian Islands, and also in the south, the same, let's say, favorite spot where we often see larger seismic activities, a very seismically active area, Tonga, Fiji, Kermadec. But maybe because the purple band is a little bit to the west of New Zealand, maybe this could also be significant for New Zealand. This is the information that we have so far. Be safe. Until next time.